The sun is the fundamental source of our life and a significant step in understanding how the universe operates. However, as we gain more information about the sun's formation process and evolution, some intriguing questions emerge. One of these questions is about the sun's lost twin. The notion that the sun once had a twin star has spurred a theory that some scientists are working on. First, let's learn about how our sun was formed and the logical explanation for the idea of it having a twin. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to my channel to stay updated on the latest videos. Let's get it on. The formation process started about 4.6 billion years ago, with the collapse of a cloud of gas and dust. The majority of this cloud gathered in a dense area that would form the core. The concentration occurring at this stage was not technically a star, or more correctly put, this formation was a protostar. The protostar stage is the stage when super-dense gas and dust collapse under their own gravity before becoming a star. During this time, the material accumulated in the core consisted of various elements, including hydrogen and helium atoms. At this period, the core was not yet hot or dense enough to produce its own energy. This process ends when the temperature and density of the protostar's core increase sufficiently. At this point, the core becomes hot and dense, and hydrogen fusion begins. These fusion reactions produce the energy of the protostar and provide the brightness of the star. This stage is when the protostar transforms into a main sequence star, which our sun is. The main sequence stage is the longest part of a star's life. Our sun is currently at this stage and has been burning in this way for about 5 billion years. In the main sequence stage, a star's core converts hydrogen to helium. During these fusion reactions, a large amount of energy is released, and this energy moves towards the star's outer layers, eventually radiating into space as light and heat from the star's surface. Our knowledge about the formation and evolution of our sun not only aids us in unraveling the mystery of our own star, but also in understanding much more. Perhaps our sun once had a twin. At first thought, the idea of our sun having a sibling might seem a bit strange, but for proponents of this theory, it makes perfect sense. According to them, the idea of our sun once having a twin is an event that occurred during the formation process of the solar system, and this theory is called the Nemesis Hypothesis. The Nemesis Hypothesis was proposed by physicists Daniel P. Whitmire and Albert A. Jackson in 1984. According to this theory, the star that was the twin of our sun would affect comets periodically in the Oort cloud at the outer boundaries of our solar system, sending them into the inner solar system. But where is this twin star? That is, if it really exists as the Nemesis Hypothesis proposes, why can't we see it? According to the theory Nemesis, the lost twin of the sun is probably still out there but extremely faint and therefore very difficult to observe. It is also thought that this star could be a red dwarf or a white dwarf. However, efforts to find Nemesis have so far been unsuccessful. Extensive observations made throughout the 1980s and 1990s found no evidence of a star at the outer boundaries of our solar system. The Gaia mission in 2014 used the latest technology to catalog stars in the vicinity of our sun, but it still could not find Nemesis. Despite all this, the Nemesis hypothesis is still found intriguing by some astronomers and scientists. This is because this theory brings up important questions about the formation and evolution of the solar system. In particular, it offers insights into where the comets in our solar system come from and the causes of mass extinction events on Earth. When we gaze into the depths of the universe, we realize that most of the stars we encounter are actually twins. Twin stars, unlike our sun, which has a planetary system revolving around it, are two star systems that revolve around each other. The scientific term for this phenomenon is binary or double star system. Considering the process of star formation, it should not be surprising that twin stars are so common. Stars usually form through the collapse of a cloud of gas and dust under gravitational force. During this process, the gas and dust must preserve their momentum, which causes them to start spinning. Ultimately, the collapsing cloud usually forms a disk, and multiple condensation centers can form within this disk. These condensation centers eventually form stars and start revolving around each other. This process can result in the formation of twin stars or multiple star systems. In fact, according to some scientists, most stars have twins at some point in their lives. This suggests that all stars could have once had a sibling star. However, over time, some of these star pairs separate. This could be due to a star pair passing through a dense region of a galaxy, or the gravitational effect of another star passing close to a star pair. Despite this idea, we do not fully understand the formation processes of all twin stars in the universe. Different twin stars can form under different conditions, and more research needs to be conducted to understand exactly what these conditions are. So why is it so important whether or not our Sun has a twin? The impacts of binary stars in the universe are varied, and they have made significant contributions to our understanding of star formation and evolution. For instance, when and how a twin star dies can provide valuable information about what will happen to the other star. Moreover, binary stars have also aided in understanding more complex star systems. These systems generally contain several stars, and understanding how they interact with each other can sometimes be challenging. However, studying binary stars allows us to better understand the dynamics of these systems. Furthermore, binary stars can contribute to our understanding of life's emergence and development in the universe. Some scientists suggest that the onset of life may be linked to the existence of binary star systems. According to this theory, a star's twin can create conditions that aid in the formation of life on planets orbiting the star. Yes, after learning that many stars have twins, the next logical question would be, what could the characteristics of the Sun's twin be? The Sun's twin would have been a yellow dwarf similar to the Sun. However, this does not mean that both would be the same age. A star's lifespan is dependent on its mass, and the Sun's twin could be slightly smaller or larger than the Sun. But typically, since stars form from the same dust cloud, their sizes are comparable. Therefore, we can assume that the Sun's twin would have a similar lifespan and evolution. However, to say anything definitive about the Sun's twin, we would need to observe that star. But this is quite difficult with current technology, as we do not know the location of the Sun's twin in our galaxy. Scientists use various methods to determine the potential location of the Sun's twin. One method is to study stars outside our solar system and determine their velocities and directions. This can help us understand what orbit the Sun's twin was in the past and where it might be now. Additionally, there are various scenarios to determine what kind of star the Sun's twin might be. The Sun's twin might have aged faster than the Sun and turned into a white dwarf. Or perhaps it is smaller than the Sun and has a longer lifespan. This would mean it could still be a main sequence star. Or perhaps the Sun's twin was larger than the Sun and experienced a supernova explosion, meaning it could now be a neutron star or a black hole. So, what is the fate of the Sun's twin? The most common theory about the Sun's twin is that this star has died by undergoing a supernova explosion and is no longer present in our galaxy. However, this is more of a speculation than a certain fact. We cannot know for sure whether the Sun's twin underwent a supernova explosion. But if this indeed happened, the supernova explosion would greatly reduce the mass of the Sun's twin and remove it from being an observable object. Also, given that our solar system is located within the Milky Way galaxy, which hosts billions of stars, it is also possible that the Sun's twin might be in another corner of our galaxy, too far away for observation. Additionally, we can consider that the Sun's twin might have been subjected to another event on a galactic scale. For example, the twin star could have had a close pass with another star, which could have altered its orbit and carried it far away from our solar system. Such events are quite common in our galaxy and have the potential to explain the fate of the Sun's twin. So, what have been the impacts of the disappearance of the Sun's twin on Earth and our solar system in general? The existence of a twin to our Sun would primarily create noticeable effects on the interstellar medium and generally on the outer boundaries of our solar system, specifically on the Oort cloud and Kuiper belt. These two regions are the outermost parts of our solar system, mostly composed of small and icy objects. The Oort cloud is located at the very edge of our solar system, where interstellar space begins. The twin of the Sun could have had a significant impact on the objects in this region. The gravitational pull of the twin star could alter the orbits of these objects and drag them towards inner regions, possibly even into the orbits of our planets. This could have increased the frequency of comets and other small bodies falling into the inner regions of our solar system. While the debate about whether a meteor or a comet caused the end of the dinosaurs continues, perhaps the Sun's twin caused a comet to collide with Earth. In addition, the gravitational effect of the Sun's twin could influence the orbits of our planets and even the overall structure of our solar system. However, determining exactly what these effects could be depends on the characteristics and past location of the Sun's twin. If the Sun indeed had a twin, and it has now disappeared, this situation must have left noticeable effects on our solar system. Firstly, the disappearance of the twin star would have caused a significant change in gravitational balances. This change would have affected the orbits of our planets and the general structure of our solar system. Moreover, the disappearance of the Sun's twin would have caused a larger amount of small icy bodies to move towards the inner regions of our solar system. In this case, a larger number of comets and other small bodies would reach the inner regions of our solar system. This could have caused major meteor and comet collisions in Earth's past. It also would have had effects on the climate systems of our solar system, especially Earth. The disappearance of the gravitational influence of the Sun's twin and the potential effects this could have on the Earth's axial tilt and rotation speed are possible scenarios. Now let's turn our attention to the efforts to find this lost twin. What methods have been used to date, and what have we learned? The endeavor to find the Sun's twin is one of the most exciting research areas in the history of modern astronomy. Many scientists have used various techniques and research methods to track the trace of a star that was born next to the Sun in the early days of our solar system and then disappeared. One of these methods is to search for interstellar objects that roam in interstellar space and are possibly coming from the Sun's twin and have been dragged into our solar system by it. For instance, an oddly shaped interstellar object discovered in 2017 and named Oumuamua was the result of such research. The peculiar shape and speed of Oumuamua suggests that it may have originated from another star system and could possibly be a remnant of the Sun's twin. Another method is to follow the potential orbit and trail of the Sun's twin. Astronomers have used star maps and galactic movements to track the trace of the Sun's twin. However, this method is fraught with difficulties as tracking stellar movements dating back billions of years is quite challenging. Finally, some scientists have investigated potential physical evidence demonstrating the existence of the Sun's twin. This evidence is interstellar dust and gas that came from the Sun's twin and is stored in the geological records of the Earth. Yet despite all these research efforts, the endeavors to find the Sun's twin have not yet reached a concrete result. As the efforts to find the lost twin of the Sun continue, there is another interesting possibility. What if this lost twin is proving its existence to us with physical traces it left in the past? Let's follow the archaeological traces of the Sun's twin. These archaeological traces are usually related to astrophysical or geological events. For instance, such as mass extinctions that recur periodically or climate changes. Many of these may have occurred under the influence of a star, the lost twin of the Sun, approaching our solar system and causing icy bodies in the Oort cloud to be thrown out, or the orbits of the inner planets to be altered during this process. For example, there is some evidence of a periodic pattern of mass extinctions that have occurred on Earth over the last 500 million years. This could indicate that the Sun's twin approached the solar system at certain intervals of time and caused a significant impact each time. However, it is important to note that such evidence is not strong enough to allow us to reach a definitive conclusion about the Sun's lost twin. These are just possibilities and estimations. However, the existence of such evidence can help better understand the existence of the Sun's twin and its impacts in the past. Finding the lost twin of the Sun continues to remain one of the biggest mysteries in the history of modern astronomy. However, scientists continue their research, and perhaps one day they may be able to solve this mystery.